tonight with you from the office of Dr. Rupert Griffith, Regional Representative for the Northeast Region of the United National Congress Alliance. Dr. Griffith, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Richard and Gregory. How are you? How are you all doing?
Well, today has been a productive day for me. Dr. Griffith, we've got some news, some breaking news, that the case that went on between yourself, Mr. Don Sylvester, Mr. Sylvester Rampur, against the UNC executive has borne some fruit today. Would you share some light on that?
Well, very much so. Today was a great day for natural justice in the UNC. As you will recall, we took the matter to the court because we felt that we were denied natural justice in the way the UNC executive handled the issue of us supporting, purportedly to support, what they referred to in quotations, a dissident group. And they didn't tell us who were these dissident persons, but they assumed we know who they were talking about. We had asked them to put this in writing specifically so we could reply to it. But what really happened, they came prepared to cross-examine us. This was on the 14th of May, on a letter that the General Secretary had written us indicating for us to explain why we should not be disciplined or suspended because we are supporting persons who are dissident persons who are going against the rules of the party, who are bringing the party into disrepute, who are threatening violence against the party. And all of these things were very nebulous, so we asked them to put it in writing and we will reply and give us some time to reply. There's lots of argument, but I think Kamala, in her wisdom, says, okay, give them another week. And I said, will I ask Mr. Pandey, will I be receiving something in writing to enable us to reply specifically to what those allegations are? Who made the allegations? What behaviors did we portray to purport that we were supporting a dissident group in what I mentioned earlier? And of course, Mr. Pandey said that they don't have any obligations to give us anything in writing. As a matter of fact, he was advised legally by Vashis Maharaja, that is so. And I replied, I asked for it again. Kamala says, give them 1 week. And when we went back on the 20th of May to another national executive meeting, the cross-examination started in chief. And they were really coming after us, everybody around the table, saying, you were at this meeting, you were at that meeting, and a whole bunch of stuff. I said, listen, there's lots of unsubstantiated allegations. Could you kindly give us this in writing? And I had sent them, we had sent them letters asking them, officially asking them to put their allegations in writing, and we will reply to it. They read the letter into the records, but ignored the request we made. And they proceeded on the 20th to cross-examine us, and I thought it was serving no useful purpose because I didn't know what I was being cross-examined about. For instance, they talk about supporting those in violence at the National Congress. I was not in my room when that occurred. I came after, and yet you're accusing me for something where I wasn't. So when I wanted to be specific what they were talking about. And they refused. Mr. Pandey was very abusive. People around the table were very abusive to us, and I felt it was serving no useful purpose, and I left. And Rampur remained behind, and what they did, they moved a motion that we should be suspended forthwith and sent to the disciplinary committee for expulsion. That was some of the requests. They moved a motion. The motion was carried with one abstention and one objection. And the rest is history. We thought that natural justice did not prevail. We were denied natural justice. We were treated with contempt, disdain, disrespect. And we felt that as senior members of the executive and hard-working members of that, if I may say so myself, but running a region of nine constituents is no easy thing. It's a difficult task keeping tabs of all the constituencies. And to treat us with such contempt and disdain with very nebulous allegations, I thought was unfair. And I thought that we would go to court and let it take its course. I did warn Mr. Pandey, if he did not follow due process and let natural justice take its course, he will have to explain himself elsewhere. And he laughed and said, a lot of people talk about going to court and they never reach. But I hope he will learn a lesson today that some people, when they say they go to court, they do, and they do get results in the court.
Now, Dr. Griffiths, this has not been the first judgment that you have gotten against Mr. Pandey. Take me from the first day in court to your first judgment and to this judgment, to the present day.
Well, the first day in court, affidavits were laid. Each side was given enough time to submit their affidavits, and they also exchanged it, and then there were replies. The opposition, let me say that the defense, which is the executive, replied asking to remove 42 items from our affidavit. The judge removed two on the grounds that they were repetitive. They had occurred elsewhere in the document. So therefore, he saw no need for them to be repeated elsewhere, which is quite normal. And he did remove those. But out of the 42, 40 remained. And the first victory we had is that the judge did not pluck out those things that the executive wanted plucked out, and they had to pay cost for that. They were given time to redo the affidavits and submit further information to the court, which they did. The court received all the information from both sides, arguments back and forth, and the judge set today's date for a judgment. So today actually was the third sitting, really, of this whole process. And today the judge was very thorough. He went from about 10 or 10:15 all the way up to about 12 o'clock today. And he was very, very firm and very, very strong in his condemnation on the way the executive handled the situation. He told them clearly that natural justice, there was abuse, and natural justice did not take place. He cautioned them about treating such serious disciplinary matters in a callous and casual way. And he ruled in our favor by definitely saying that, listen, he found that natural justice did not take place, and he ruled in our favor.
What is the next step from here as we go forward? What are you and the group doing now that you've gotten this judgment in your favor?
Well, the next step, it was so devastating for the executive, and the cost would be so exorbitant, because you could well imagine that there were a lot of lawyers involved, senior counsel on both sides, and there were lots of paperwork, lots of research went on, and the judge cautioned them that, you know, this case is going to be of high cost. And having looked at the information he had, he felt that the executive had a very, very weak case, and he advised that the parties meet and talk to see if the matter could be resolved outside, so we would not have to go to the next step, the trial. And this notwithstanding the fact that he has set pre-trial and trial dates. The trial dates is set, well, those will be the final dates for March 15, 16, and 17, someplace around there, next year. But between now, November and March, there's lots of information the attorneys will have to provide. They'll have to keep the court abreast on discussions, if any, and so that the whole matter can be handled legally.